Now we are going to see the passage 2. So let me read out the passage clearly. So the great advantage of early rising is that one can start one's work long before others. The early riser has done a large amount of hard work before other men have got out of bed. Early in the morning, the mind is fresh and no sounds or noises disturb our attention. The work done at the time is generally well done. Also, one finds time to take some exercise in the fresh morning air. Exercise supplies him with a good deal of energy that enables him to work hard until the evening. By beginning so early, he knows that he has plenty of time to do his work thoroughly. He does not have to hurry over any part of his work. He gets to sleep long before midnight. At that time, sleep is most refreshing. After a night's sound rest, he rises early next morning in good health, ready for the labor of a new day. So let us concentrate. So this passage speaks about what? It speaks about the advantage of early rising and what are the benefits of early rising. Let us see here. So the great advantage of early rising is that one can start one's work long before others. So if you get out of the bed early in the morning there, just you can start your works, you can start your works early, long before others. Others refer to your family members or your friends, whatever, whoever they may be. So this is the one advantage if you get up early in the morning. So the early riser has done a large amount of hard work before other men have got out of bed. So what he says here, the early riser has done a large amount of hard work before other men have got out of bed. Means if you rise early from the bed there, definitely you will get all kinds of activities to be done before they get out of their bed there. So this is the one advantage. So early in the morning, the mind is fresh. So means when you are getting out of sleep there, definitely your mind will be so fresh and no sounds will be there. Means sometimes pollutions will be there, no? So here no sound pollution will be there, no noise pollutions will be there, and which really disturb our concentration and attention. He is using the word attention. So in this way, just we will not be disturbed anything there if you get up early in the morning. So the work done at that time is generally well done. Means, so if you have the habit of getting up from the bed early, so your things will be done very smoothly and you can enjoy the entire day. Also, one finds time to take some exercise in the fresh morning air. Means you should cultivate the habit of doing exercise in the morning fresh air. So in this morning fresh air, your health may become sound. So in this way, just should cultivate the habit. Exercise supplies him with a good deal of energy. Means, so what is the benefits? What are the benefits of exercise, doing exercises? So he says here, exercise supplies him. It means here refers to the person who gets up early in the morning with a good deal of energy. Means you get fresh energy, that so that energy enables means makes him to work hard until the evening without any tiredness. Just you can do your work until the evening. So this is the benefit of getting up early in the morning. By beginning so early, he knows that he has plenty of time to do his work thoroughly. Thoroughly means totally, completely, satisfactorily. Just you can do your work there. This is called thoroughly. Means, so when you get happy there, so when you are satisfied with your work there, definitely you will be satisfied. In this way, he has used the word thoroughly. Now, he does not have to hurry over any part of his work. So if you get up early there, so no need to going here and there, running, rushing here and there for attending your works there. So he does not have to hurry over any part of his work. Your works will be smoothly done there. He gets to sleep long before midnight. If you get up early in the morning there, so he gets to sleep long before midnight. So why this sentence is brought into the passage there? Nowadays, this generation people, this generation students are so doing overnight, so you can say just they are late, till late night, just they are going through something else, so which are not at all healthy for our lives. So he gets to sleep long before midnight. So at that time, sleep is most refreshing. So midnight sleep is, so that should be sound sleep, and that definitely refresh your mind, right? After a night's sound rest, he rises early next morning in good health, ready for the labor of a new day. So he has used the word here, he for the labor of a new day. So labor means don't concentrate on the person's labor, means your work of a day. Your work will be done smoothly. Labor of a day means work of a day. So this is the passage given to you. So let us note down some hard words there. So advantage is one hard word, and start once long before others. The early riser has some amount before the other men have got out of bed. Early in the morning, mind is fresh and no sounds, noises disturb. Attention is another word. Just you should not make a note of the hard words there, and you should make use these hard words in your day-to-day life. The work done at that time is generally well done. So no hard work too. Also, one finds time to take some exercise. So exercise, all of you know pretty well, in the fresh morning air. Exercise supplies him with a good deal of energy that makes you to do the things there. This is enables means that forces you, that makes you to do the works easily. Has plenty of time to do his work thoroughly. Thoroughly means completely, right? Satisfactorily, you can use the word also sometimes. He does not have to hurry. So hurry is another hard word you can say. If you feel, jo hurry becomes, and thoroughly is another word. Over any part of his work, he gets sleep long before midnight. So you know, midnight is okay. At that time, sleep is most refreshing is another word. Just you please underline, make a note of this word. Refreshing means freshing, and refreshing means so your mind will be fresh. So if you get sound sleep there, your mind will refresh. So this is called refreshing. So this is another word here you should underline here. After a night's sound rest, sound rest means peaceful rest. So sound rest means, so having sound sleep is called sound rest. He rises early next morning in good health, ready for the labor of a new day. So in this way, so labor is the word which is used in the place of work. Okay. So these are the hard words. So 6 to 7 hard words are there that you should make use of these words into your day-to-day life. And try to use some meaningful sentences, prepare some meaningful sentences also. Now let us see some questions. The great advantage of early rising is that one start one's work long before others. What is the great advantage of early rising? So this is my question here. So what would be the answer? One start one's work long before others. This is the one advantage. Means you should make some meaningful questions, and you should immediately give the answers on your own without depending on anybody or anything else. The early riser has done a large amount of hard work before other men have got out of bed. So here I am concentrating on singular and plural. See here, one plural number is there. The early riser has done a large amount of hard work before other men. Men is given. So men is plural number of man. M-A-N man is singular number, whereas M-A-N men is plural number. You should don't say man's, man and men. So you should concentrate here, singular number and plural number. Okay, have got out of bed early in the morning, mind is fresh and no sounds, noises disturb our attention. So in this purpose sentence, what is verb here? Early in the morning, the mind is fresh and no sounds, no noises disturb our attention. So here, which is the verb here? Disturb becomes the verb. Okay. So you should concentrate here. Disturb is the verb. Immediately you should recall the three forms of the word disturb. Disturb is first form, disturbed and disturbed. This is regular verb. So in this way, every verb has got three forms. So when we discuss tenses there, just I'll explain how many forms will be there and what are the three forms. Okay. Now let us concentrate on the passage. The work done at that time is generally well done. At that time refers to, so when you get up early in the morning, that becomes at that time. That time refers to early in the morning here, and as far as this passage is concerned, generally well done. Also, one finds time to take some exercise in the fresh morning air. So fresh morning air is given. So fresh morning air. So what, air becomes noun or pronoun? So that you should concentrate here. Air becomes definitely noun. Exercise supplies him with a good deal of energy, and that enables him to work hard until the evening. So which is the time expression word here? Evening is the time expression word. So you should concentrate on the time expression words also. Evening is time expression word, and enables is the verb here. Enables means makes. By beginning so early, he knows that he has plenty of time to do his work thoroughly. So thoroughly becomes here. So adverb, completely. He does not have to hurry over any part of his work. Any part of his work, any activity of his day-to-day activities. He gets to sleep long before midnight. At that time, sleep is most refreshing. After a night's sound rest, he rises early next morning in good health, ready for the labor of a new day. This is how it should be there. Now let us concentrate the given questions. What are the questions that are given here in the under the passage? The first question is, what advantage does an early riser have over others? Just I have given you the sentence now. So see the answer here, which is the suitable one. An early riser has done a large amount of hard work before other men have got out of bed. This is one sentence, one option is given like this. The second option is, you should concentrate on all the four options. So an early riser does not get late to office. So that is not at all mentioned in the passage. Office word is not at all means. So while answering the questions from the passage, you should concentrate whether those words are seen in the passage or not. Then just you should go for the answer. An early riser has time for enjoyment. This is also not given. Enjoyment word is also not given. So just you can delete this one. The fourth one is, an early riser has time for prayer. This is also not at all mentioned. So our answer is, so A is the answer there. Okay. An early riser has done a large amount of hard work before other men have got out of bed. So this is the suitable option here. Now let us concentrate on the second question. The work done in the morning is sometimes good, always good, often not complete, generally well done. So just you please search for these words, that whether they are seen in the sentence or not. The early riser has done a large amount of hard work before other men have got out of bed. Early in the morning, the mind is fresh and no sounds or noises disturb our attention. The work done at that time is generally well done. Whether these words are seen in the passage or not, so those words are seen. So this is the suitable answer for that one. So that is generally well done. D is the answer there. So always good is not mentioned, sometimes good is not mentioned, often not complete is not mentioned. Okay. So D is the answer for that one. Okay. Now let us concentrate on the eighth question. Let us see here. What is the use of exercise? So the options are given like this. It makes one healthy and happy. The second option is, B option is, it supplies one with a good deal of energy. C option speaks about it makes one fat, and D option speaks about it keeps one away from disease. So our concentration must be only on the sentence that is seen in the passage. So let us concentrate on the sentence. It supplies one with a good deal of energy. So B is the right one. So let us concentrate on the sentence also. Let us go for the sentence. Okay, right? The work done at that time is generally well done. Also, one finds time to take some exercise in the fresh morning air. Exercise supplies him with a good deal of energy. These are the words that are helpful for to answer this 8th question. So this is the right one here. So our answer is supplies him with a good deal of energy. Okay, right. Now let us concentrate on the 9th question. The word thoroughly means, so occasionally is given, frequently is given, completely is given, rarely is also given there. So I have given you while explaining you. So thoroughly is nothing but completely. Completely is the suitable answer there. C option is the right one. Now the 10th question is, which one of the following is not an advantage of early rising according to the passage? So just to try to understand the given sentence also, the given question also, which one of the following is not an advantage of early rising according to the passage? So means sometimes your questions may be twisted, so you should concentrate on the question, given question also. So A option is given like this: an early riser does a large amount of work before others get out of bed. This is okay, but what it speaks, not an advantage. So that is why that is not at all suitable here. And B is, an early riser has time for exercise. This is also okay, but so your the answer here, the question speaks negative way, so you should go for the negative one. So B is wrong one here. And C is, an early riser has plenty of time to do his work thoroughly. This is also okay, but so we should give the negative, not at the disadvantage should be mentioned here. So this is wrong. And D option, let us concentrate on the D option: an early riser has a lot of time for outdoor activities. This is not an advantage. So D is the right one there. D is the right one. So this, in this way, your concentration must be on each and every sentence and each and every word, and you should go according to the contextual meaning. So this is the end of this passage 2.